السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا محمد. Today is the last session in Surah Qaf. And last time we talk about that this is the conclusion of Surah Qaf from ayah number 36 till the end. And Allah تبارك وتعالى just summarize the central theme of this surah, which is the proof of the resurrection and the day of judgment. And we said that in this surah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he began this surah with the statement of the disbeliever when they said, how can we come to life again after we become a dust? And he tackled this issue from different angles: his absolute knowledge, number two, reflecting upon the universe, number three, looking at the history and how many nations Allah destroyed when they deny the message. And in the middle of the surah, there's a journey with every single human being. Since Allah created him or her, Allah tabaraka ta'ala told us he knows everything, even when your soul whispered to yourself. And وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. And there's always two angels record everything, and the death will come with the truth. And he talk about that debate in the day of judgment between that person when the two angels, one on his right and one on his left, they will brought the record to Almighty in that divine court. And he talk about the people of hellfire and the people of Jannah. Jazakallah. So in the end, he said also, وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ. He said, how many nations or many civilizations Allah destroyed. He said, فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ. نَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ. That many translation, they say just travel. But the deep meaning here is naqabu. It means they build a lot of buildings, amazing civilization, and in the end, can they escape from the qadr of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? Then he said, إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. This truth, only the one who can take benefit of is the one who has a heart. We said this means not a physical heart, but spiritual heart. So always we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to revive our hearts, to remain our heart alive. Because Allah talk a lot in Quran that some hearts, some physical hearts are dead, and some physical hearts are alive. Only bi dhikri Allah. With dhikr of Allah, tabarakata, will remember Allah, will reflect upon the words of Allah, your heart will become alive. May Allah tabarakata give our hearts life. That's the last thing. Today, I think we took this also. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبٍ. We created heavens and earth in 6 days. 6 days here, days in Quran doesn't mean 24 hours. Day in Arabic can be 24 hour, can be one moment, can be any long period of time. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that one day could be 1,000 years of these 24 hours. He said in Surah Al-Sajda, وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِّمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. He said one day, according to the knowledge of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, is equal 1,000 years of our calculation here. And he said also in Surah Al-Ma'arij, في يوم كان مقداره 50,000 سنة. He say يوم, day, but that day will last for 50,000 years. It means يوم doesn't mean always 24 hours. So when he said created, he created heavens and earth in 6 days, that doesn't mean 24 hours. Doesn't mean 1 week. That's days. Allah, only Allah knows how long these days. And now with this discovery of a lot of science nowadays, we understand that these days is not just days, they are a long period of time. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned this ayah in the end to also indicate and indicate His absolute knowledge, His absolute power. He created everything in the heavens, in the earth, in between. وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِن لُغُوبِ. Many, or all the translation, they say tiring. But Arabic language is very concise and deep. There is a lot of synonyms for tiring. In Quran even, we have nasab, we have lughub, we have ta'ab. So Ahlul Jannah said, الذي لا يمسنا فيها نصب ولا يمسنا فيها لغوب. نصب is tiredness, that really you became tired. But لغوب is very minimum of tired, that when someone is he do his work, but he feel he didn't do the work in that stable, in his full capacity. It means لغوب here, just a little bit of tiredness. And then he said, وَمَا مَسَّنَا. مَسَّنَا, even in Arabic, when you say مَا مَسَّنِي, it means never touch me in this. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, He has absolute power. So you talk about how Almighty will bring us back after we die. Look at the heavens, at the earth, at what is in between. All this amazing creation Allah created. And you still doubt, can He brought us back? Subhanallah. Then he said, this is the end now. This is now new for this lesson. What's after all of this? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala now talked to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to every leader, every reader, he read this Quran. He said to his Prophet, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَىٰ مَا يَقُولُونَ. Be patient of what they say. What they say, bear in mind that this is Makki, in Makki period. And Rasulullah ﷺ spent 13 years after prophethood in Mecca. These 13 years is the most difficult in his life. And in these 13 years, the majority of Quran revealed, around 90 surahs, 90 surahs in Quran revealed in Mecca. And these 13 years, they abused Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He woke in Mecca and all the children, they say, this is the magician, this is the liar, this is the mad, this is the crazy. And he's the most honest. Subhanallah, this has hurt him a lot. In Mecca period, when this surah revealed, many of his companions, they tortured a lot. Some of them died, like Sumayya and Yasir. They migrated to Abyssinia just to find a place safe for safety. So there is a lot of challenges. However, Allah said, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَىٰ مَا يَقُولُونَ. Be patient. Your reaction should be only patience. You're surprised that in Mecca period, in these 13 years, there's a command from Allah to the all companions in Mecca. If anyone tortured you, remain silent and be patient. It's haram in Mecca period for the early companions to react to all these challenges. If someone them slap them, he should remain silent. Why? Because Islam came to Arabia, Arab people. You have to understand the mentality of Arab in Jahiliyyah. The Arab in Jahiliyyah, war, initiate war for them, it's just like piece of cake. They spent 40 years fighting each other, the cousins, Bakr and Taghlib. Bakr Taghlib is two tribes, but they are cousins. Why they fight each other? Because one of them killed the camel of one person from another tribe, camel. So they fight each other for 40 years. Another famous war, Dahis wal Ghabra, very famous war between cousins also, Abs with Ubyan. Why? They were racing between horses, and one of the horses is just about to win, and one person just threw a bone to that horse to distract him, and then they start the war. In Arab in Arabia, it just if you slap him, he will slap you 10 times. That's their mentality. Quran came and he said, be patient. He want to change that mentality, not to become not to humiliate them, no. But they want them, when you initiate a war or fighting, should be for the sake of Allah. Should be in justice. Not just because your tribe want that. Not because yourself, someone, you want to do that. When they understand this very well, when they migrated to Medina, then he give them permission to react. That's why we will recite in Quran, أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا. أُذِنَ, it means Allah gave permission to those who receive a lot of oppression, that now they can react for that. Permission. After now, this is the Muslim, when Allah Ta'ala said, now you can do this, he will do. You can react, you do. Muslim, he act only according to what Allah and his messenger said, not according to his desires. So in this tough time in Mecca, Allah said, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ. Be patient. This is a message for us also. When you see a lot of things in media against Muslim, for example, or Muslim Islamophobia, or around the world, what's your reaction? Hold yourself. Be patient. The best reaction is to show them Islam by character in this country. To come on time, to don't park on any place not parking, not to cheat or deceive when you do insurance, not to escape from anything rules here. Smile always to all the people. When you have non-Muslim neighbors, show them the excellence of Islam. By this, they will know what is Islam. Because majority of these people, they have good in their hearts. The problem is only the media. What they know about Islam is just about media. They don't know the real Islam. Who will show them Islam? If we don't show them Islam, who will show them Islam? So that's why Allah said to His Prophet ﷺ, be patient, hold yourself. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Then, but how can we be patient in this level? He said after that, He give us that source of strength. How can we hold ourselves? How can we face all the challenges and we still steadfast? How? He said, وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. How? By tasbih and hamd. By coming close to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. By praising Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala a lot. By doing a lot of dhikr, a lot of prayer. When you do that, you become close to Allah, then instead you'll become like Rasulullah sallam. They abuse him, they did a lot of things bad to him, and he himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart is full of mercy upon them. Allah described Rasulullah sallam, his feeling towards non-Muslim, in the end of Surah At-Tawbah, لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم. He said that Allah the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, how he feel towards non-Muslim, non-Muslim, because he say after that بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم. It means these two qualities is for all humanity. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, his heart is عزيز عليه ما عنتم. He bother him when you reject this message. That bother him a lot. He want goodness for you. He want every single person to accept this message. Then he will be safe in the day of judgment. حريص عليكم. He try his best for people to convey, to accept this message. He wish that all the humanity will become Muslims because he wants safety for them. That's how Rasulullah SAW look at them. That Allah SAW say to him, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِلَّمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. What does بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ mean? He said in Surah Al-Kahf, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ. You want to kill yourself out of this regret that they don't accept the message. So Allah Ta'ala reassure his Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, relieve his Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, don't worry. That's your job, just to convey the message. And he gave us how we can be strong, come close to Allah. How? سبح بحمد ربي. Tasbih is glorification. When you say Subhanallah, what does that mean? It means you glorify your Lord. So should everyone, every time you say Subhanallah, something come to your mind. Every time you say Astaghfirullah, something come to your mind. What comes to your mind is very important. Otherwise, your tasbih will be just by your tongue. When you say Subhanallah, when you see something amazing, a nice scene, a nice flowers, a nice, you say Subhanallah. Because when you say that, you glorify your Lord that He created this beauty. In another hand also, when you say someone, Allah created him from a mingle of fluid, he raised by the rizq of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And when he become adult, he tried to go to do everything against to his Lord. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala still provide for him everything. You say, Subhanallah. It means Subhanallah for his forbearance. That he provide even the people who against him, he never cut the rizq. Subhanallah. Subhanallah, when you say that, when you know a lot of about your Lord, every time you discover something else, you say, Subhanallah, I know nothing about my Lord. He deserves more and more and more. So what comes to your mind is very important. Every Muslim, they say always, Astaghfirullah. What comes to your mind? You'll say, oh, the sins I commit before, that's good. But do you know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to say Astaghfirullah in every single gathering 100 times. I always wonder, what comes to the mind of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he say Astaghfirullah? He didn't commit sins. So why he say Astaghfirullah a lot? Because the more you know your Lord, the more you will say Astaghfirullah. Because when you know your Lord, you realize that if you spend all your life in the sake of Allah, this is nothing compared to what he deserves. Rasulullah is the most knowledgeable in this. So he always say Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. So Astaghfirullah is a big word, but it just depends what comes to your mind. That's why one of the awliya, salihin, said, Istighfaruna yahtaju ila istighfar. How we say Astaghfirullah, we need to say Astaghfirullah for the way we say Astaghfirullah. Because we say Astaghfirullah and our mind in everywhere. Astaghfirullah, 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 Astaghfirullah. This is a big word. You ask for forgiveness. You realize that what you do is nothing compared to what he deserved, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So Allah said, فَسَبِّحْ بِهِ. That's tasbih, glorification. بِحَمْدِهِ. Tasbih many times comes with hamd. Because sometimes you say, أَسْتَغْفِرْ Subhanallah. And you remember that Allah tabaraka give you permission to mention his name. That's big blessings. So you say, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah is always after Subhanallah. Subhanallah and then Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah is glorification of the Lord, of our Lord. This azama, this jalal. Straight away, Alhamdulillah, that I know this azama and jalal, why I'm in this life. Alhamdulillah that I know the purpose of this. Alhamdulillah that I mention his names. But he mentioned something. He said, before sun rising and before sun setting. It means this is adhkar in the morning and adhkar in the evening. Or salatul fajr or salatul asr. Probably this is because mentioned a lot in Quran. It's about adhkar. Why adhkar is very important in the morning before sun rising and in the evening before sun setting. Because number one, this is the harmony between you and the creation of Allah. The sun is go from the east to the west. So that's movement of sun. And Allah told us that all the creation made tasbih of Allah. But we don't know how. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Everything made tasbih. The sun made tasbih. The moon made tasbih. The tree, the rock, the stone, the water, everything. But he said, وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ. But you can't imagine how they make tasbih. So the sun go there and there. We also make tasbih in this. Number two, morning is the beginning of the day. So every time Allah gave us a new day to live, that's big ni'mah. Because He can took your soul while you are sleeping. That's why Rasulullah Sallam, once he wake up, before he make wudu, Alhamdulillah alladhi radda alayya ruhi. Oh Allah, Alhamdulillah that you give me, return my soul to me and give me chance to live another day. If that's a blessing, then start your day with Salatul Fajr. That's why Salatul Fajr should be a bit long. Allah said, وَقُرْآن الْفَجْرِ. Not Salatul Fajr, Qur'an al-Fajr. Why? It's indication that recite long Qur'an in Salatul Fajr. Because this is the first moment of morning. Start your day with Dhikrullah to make that day barakah. And then before sun setting, because this is the end of the day and the beginning of the night. That way also you start that with dhikr of Allah. So adhkar is very important. So for those who, young people, if you don't have this habit of adhkar, go to any bookshop and try to buy a small book just about the adhkar in morning and evening. Make this habit, build this habit. And after that, go to a different level, know the meaning. If you know the meaning of adhkar and reflect, it's amazing. It's just sitting, iman will increase, subhanallah. That half an hour you sit after fajr, do adhkar and reflect upon adhkar, increase your iman, subhanallah, unbelievable. But only when you reflect upon the meaning. So he said, قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. Then he said, ومن الليل فسبح وأدبار السجود. And then also made tasbih at night, which is قيام الليل. So mention the name of your Lord a lot at night. Allah emphasized night a lot in Quran. Because night, when everyone is sleeping, you know, night is a time for rest. Is that right? Yes, but majority of people, they want rest only for their bodies. Allah created us from body and soul. So both need rest at night. The rest of the body is by sleeping. What about the soul? The rest of the soul is by qiyamul layl. That's why Rasulullah SAW, he used to sleep in the beginning of the night to give his body the rest. And all the scientists now said that the first hours from the night is so barakah. So Rasulullah SAW sleep. And then in the middle of the night, he wake up to give the rest to his soul. This soul, when you wake up before Fajr, that's the time for the soul. That's what Allah said, إِنَّ نَاشِئَةَ اللَّيْلِ هِيَ أَشَدُّ وَطْءًا. You know what? When you put your footstep in the ground, there's a mark in the ground. Is that right? That's also when you recite Quran at night, it make a mark in your heart. You never forget that meaning you recite at night. It's a special moment. Everyone is sleeping. Only those who love Allah so much sleep for qiyam, wake up for qiyamul layl. Because you see in our dunya that if someone loves someone or love a woman, he will wake up in the middle of the night just for calling. Waiting for that call all the night. He's not tired. He's tired, but that out of love. So when you increase the love of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, qiyamul layl will be a habit. If you missed one day, you will feel all the day you are not right. There's something missing. That's the food of the soul. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَاسْجُدْ لَهُ وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ. Sujood here, sujood is prostrating. Sujood is not the plural of sajda. Sujood is the masdar, is the ing, prostrating. So how is after the prostrating? Sujood here is indicating for salah. Salah called sujood. In Arabic, you can take part of that process and named all the process by that part. So for example, sujood, it means the salah in whole. But why he picked sujood? Because sujood is where you put your forehead on the ground, that show the humbleness before your Lord, show that you are slave and servant to Allah. Adbar as-sujood, it means the time after salah. So after salah, sit down and made adhkar. An interesting thing here that Rasulullah SAW used to say immediately after assalamu alaykum, Astaghfirullah. Why he say Astaghfirullah? He just did the best type of worship with his salah. Because to remind you, sometimes you did very nice salah with khushu', so you thought you did something great to your Lord that you deserve Jannah, no doubt. I did a lot for my Lord. Say Astaghfirullah. Humble yourself. Whatever we do is nothing to what he deserves. So Rasulullah SAW says, Astaghfirullah. After every sajda in salah, Rabbi ighfirli. After qiyamul layl, wal mustaghfirina bil ashar, istighfar in sahar. Just remind us, that's great, but nothing compared to what he deserves. Then he said, وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِي الْمُنَادِ مِنْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ. استمع is listen out. يَوْمَ يُنَادِي الْمُنَادِ, when the caller will call. Who's the caller? That's Israfil. When he blow in the horn, and all the people will come to the resurrection.
يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ.
When Israfil scream and everyone will listen attentively, they will come. Sayha literally is screaming. So it's just indicated for what Israfil will do. Why the Day of Judgment start with this? Because anything important start with announcement. Salah is very important, so we have Adhan. Allahu Akbar. Announcement for something very important. The Day of Judgment has announcement. which is that screaming, everyone will come to that day of judgment. بالحق. Either يسمعون بالحق, they will listen to that truth, because حق always in the day of judgment. That's the day of truth. Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala will reveal all the doubt, everything will become very clear. ذلك يوم الخروج. You know, in the beginning of the surah, when he talk about when the water come down to the land and Allah Ta'ala brought out the plants, he said that that's the way you will come up, come out from your graves. He has said ذلك يوم الخروج. خروج literally is exist, is exit. When you exit from this door, the exit is خروج. But what does that mean? It means we will come out from our graves. When we heard that screaming, that announcement, inna nahnu nuhyi wa numitu wa ilayna al-masir. This ayah, if you taste Arabic, the way Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala structured this ayah is amazing. There's a lot of emphasis and exclusively. So I will translate it. The translation in English, they don't convey the meaning of this. They don't say the meaning. I will translate different according to what I understand from Arabic. Indeed, we are. نحنو. Only we. Because inna, na, and نحنو, the same. So why he repeat the same pronoun? That's for emphasis. It means indeed we are and only we. نحي ونميت. نحي, this noon also is we also, another we. We are the one who give lives. نميت, we are the one who make people die. So we are the one who take the souls. So وإلينا المصير, in Arabic this now change in order. The default is المصير إلينا, but he rearranged the order of the sentence to emphasize. So it will be indeed we are and only we are the one who give lives, we are the one who take the lives, and for and only for us will be the final return. We, only. Why? Because this is the main theme. نحيي ونميت. Who gives lives? Allah. Who takes lives? Allah and only Allah. No one else. So he emphasized this. And then he said, يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير. يوم تشقق الأرض, when the earth split out, when the earth opened. تشقق is only used for planet, when the earth is just open a little bit and that small planet come out, very weak, grow up till become a tree. Human beings in their graves, the same process. This earth will open, split, and then they all will come up, come out to the day of resurrection. Sira'an, they hurry up. Because they just listen to that screaming and everyone is coming out from the graves. They hurry up to that special land and they will stay there for 50,000 years. Everyone will be accountable. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. Hashr is gathering. That resurrection is easy for us. عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. He didn't say يَسِيرٌ عَلَيْنَا. No. Only for us is easy. Everything is easy for Allah تبارك وتعالى. Then the last ayah is when he now say again the day of judgment. You know, all the surah is about this. And he end that surah that the all people and creation now in that special land for judgment. That's the last now thing. Then he said to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. We are the only one knows everything what they say. Because he starts the surah of the statement. They say, how can we come alive after we become dust? Allah said, نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. We know everything they say in this life. Every action, every movement, every step they do against our path. We know everything. Don't worry about them, O Prophet. Your job is just to convey the message. You are not here in this earth to force them to believe. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارِ. Jabbar, it means someone who force someone to believe. O Prophet, your job is not to force them. Don't worry about them. Your job is just to convey the message. This is an indicator for Muslims. Sometimes you say, did I convey the message? Don't worry about who will open the hearts is only Allah. Nuh spent long time and his own son and own wife become non-Muslims. Does that mean he didn't convey the message? No. That's also a message for us in this country. Sometimes we look at one Muslim family, practicing parents, and when one of their children, they went far away from Islam, straight away some people say, look at these parents. They abuse that parents. They say, this is just their fault. That's their fault. Subhanallah. Hidayah is not in the hands of a human being. Their fault if they don't bring their children to masajid. Yes, that's their fault. Their fault if they don't talk about Allah and His Messenger in the house. That's absolutely their fault. But if they do their best, what's the results? That's in the hands of Allah. And only Allah. So don't, talk or backbite some parents because of this issue. Hidayah is only from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Our job is to convey the message, but convey it in the best way. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارِ. That's not your duty is not to open their hearts. فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدِ. It's wa'idi. Wa'idi, my warning. ذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ. It means your method of warning is Quran. That's the last word here. It means, brothers and sisters, Quran is the best method for warning. That's why we need to understand Quran very well. And we need to reflect upon Quran, because this is the best way to warn people. When you warn people, recite the ayat and say, Allah said. Don't talk about the day of judgment, but you say, oh, if you don't do that, you'll go to hellfire. If you don't, no, quote Allah Almighty. Because we are a human being, we are on the same level. When you quote that, Allah is the one who said that, that's something above all of us. فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ. So Quran is our fuel. Quran is our methodology. Quran after that, and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make all our life is just spending with understanding Quran, reflect upon Quran, acting upon Quran, and make our character and our behavior according to the Quran. May Allah tabaraka make us the du'ats of all our neighbors here, co-workers. May Allah fill our heart with mercy upon them and give us ability to convey the message to every corner in this world. May Allah tabaraka ta'ala relieve all the pain, our brothers and sisters, especially in Gaza. May Allah strengthen them. May Allah give them patience. May Allah give them yaqeen. May Allah give them steadfast. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala abdi rasuli Sayyidina Muhammad. Next week, inshallah, we start with Surah Al-Hujurat, which is Madani Surah, completely different themes from this Surah.